we're dealing with here is setting up a local food economy system. See, the curriculum for the schools are not based on the necessary demand that our people need right now. You got to set up your own curriculum that's going to address the issues that you immediately face right now. Yeah. And our issue is food.
Environment that mimics a natural forest setting. Forest, nobody rakes up the leaves. Nobody straightens up the ground. The surface has a lot of different highs and lows, places where water gathers, places where water runs off. So that's the reason for the beds not having a very, what we might be used to as a very systematic, uniform look to them. They have natural pattern, which allows for exactly that, for places for water to settle. A bed that is raised like this has a lot more growing surface than a flat bed, because we can grow all along the side and up to the top.
The best soil you'll ever find is where? Out in the forest. You ever go to the forest and dig up under those trees? That soil is so rich. Am I right?
He's got his own ego.
He's got his own system, but that's what these trees are for, the Polonian trees, and also the canopy system and everything. In other words, you are developing a forest type environment to help organic matter to build up, for it can be utilized by the different life forms that's in the ground. As long as the life forces, the life energy, whichever form it comes in, is happy, then the soil is going to be right to grow food. They're going to take care of your soil to make sure it's balanced and everything. You don't have to even worry about the nitrogen, the phosphorus, the sulfur, the calcium. You don't even have to be bothered with that.
Adonijah always plants more than one of any fruit. That creates a mini ecosystem that attracts native birds, native insects, butterflies, all the things that are necessary to keep the whole chain going as far as plant pollination and pest control.
LA has the best weather to actually grow most of all of their food. They could grow 30-40% of the vegetables and fruit that they eat right now. They'll be more nutritious for them. They'll save money on gas, money on time shopping, and beautify the community. Right? It'll bring back the native birds, it'll bring back the animal activity. That will plant trees the following two seasons. Mm. That's a natural system. Here's the cherry tree. The cherry tree, you eat from it, the birds eat from it. Right? What isn't eaten falls on the ground and gives cherry trees hundreds, thousands of them. We go back and we plant the trees that come from this tree,
right,
in this community. That's at least 300 cherry trees. Who would be buying cherry trees in 2 to 3 years?
The intention is to create local food economy enterprises. And when we state that, we mean that the food is grown locally and sold locally, also processed and handled locally, if it's going to be canned, if it's going to be turned into a product. All of that is done locally to minimize the cost and to accentuate the freshness and vitality of the food.
We've been living in an artificial environment for the last probably 100 years. All right? Everything that you've been around is artificial now. The way cities are planned isn't a natural environment.
Exactly.
We haven't even started to live yet. You see what I mean? We haven't even started to live. So the opportunity here is tremendous.
It's revolutionary.
Because if people planted their environment up properly, they're not going to be the same person. Because your environment is going to dictate your behavior.
Most people are more likely to begin, if we're in the garden, we're more likely to begin to eat from the garden, which means we're more likely to begin eating food that is not cooked. Because we're just out here doing what we're doing, and there's a nice big fig, or there's a big passion fruit, there's some beautiful cherries, you rinse them, we eat them, boom. When that happens, we're talking about live enzymes again coming back into our intestinal flora. We're talking about microbes, healthy bacteria, all these different things that normally get neutralized during the processing and cooking part.
Right now, if we don't take care of our food issue, right, then we have a serious problem in 5 to 10 years. We have a problem right now. Where can we go and buy organic produce? Mm-hmm. We can't even buy organic produce around here.
Schoolyards, public parks, green spaces along streets and freeways, all of these that are already planted up can be replanted with functional, productive plants. All the plants that are non-functional, meaning they bear no fruit for humans or animals, can be substituted and switched to where it's a functional plant. An apple, a persimmon, a loquat, because it's all getting watered anyway.
And when you look at the power, is that all of these fruits here can produce, all right, a tree.
Lime.
Yes. Now, these right here are tangerine. All of the fruits on here have seeds, which would be producing a fruit tree, which will outlive you and your grandchildren. We don't have too much of a problem. In fact, we're very fortunate being here. Because we still have weather, we still have water, we don't have a problem. What we do have though, is that we have systems that have been embedded in us for year after year after year, and now it's like on automatic, so people think this is the way it should be. So they just need a prototype.